Hey everyone, and welcome to our setup for our Hikvision intercom system. And we are going to be setting up our Android panel and showing you how to connect it. So there's two ways to set up this panel. You can do it literally on the panel itself by using the touch screen, or you could do it through IVMS 4200. So this way we're going to be using the touch screen panel, and we're going to flip over in a second to the live view, and I'm going to show you exactly how to set that up. Okay, so this is our little setup we have here. Everything's connected by just basic cable, RJ45 Ethernet cable. We have our outdoor door station connected to a switch, and our switch is then connected to our station and connected to the internet. Okay, so we'll quickly run through the items and then I'll show you how to set one up. It really doesn't take long. They've done a really good job, Hikvision, to set this up through the panel. So you'll see how it goes in a second. But these are the items we're using. So this is our new Android station, okay? It's very handy. You can have a Hik Connect built into it. I'm sure we're gonna be talking about this a lot. This is our regular door station we're using. We've got a whole series on this. If you want to check out the links below, you can add different modules to it. But it's just the regular door station. You can connect to most of the door stations to this Android unit. There's no problem. And this is our switch unit we'll be using. Okay, so let me flip over to the live view and show you how to set one up. It only takes a couple of minutes. And see you there. Cheers. Bye. Okay, so we're now over to our little demo setup, and here is our switch. So our yellow cable is connected to our network, our internet, and we have two cables here, simple Ethernet cables we're going to connect our devices to. All right, so first of all, we'll start with our door station. Simply just clicks in the back there. Okay, and our Android station. It just takes a few seconds for them to power up and get going. And this setup only takes a couple of minutes. So Hikvision done a really good job with the software. Nice and easy. I did update the firmware earlier on these items, so if there is any problems, I advise you checking out the links below how to update the firmware, just in case. But there's definitely something you should do as soon as you can. It's highly recommended. All right, that's our door station powered up. The lovely sound they put there, Hikvision. Thanks for that. Very charming buzzer. All right then. So it's a pretty straightforward setup. We have to enter a password. Yeah, create a password. Okay, let's call it intercom. 1, 2, 3. Okay, you might want to select something a bit more harder to crack than that. Okay, so we choose our language, set to English already, perfect. We go next. Okay then, yes, we want to enable DHCP on both devices. So here we can just click on this, and our current IP is 192, which just changed to 10.44.147. Okay, but you do get an error, DNS error, don't worry about that. It always seems to come up, but it works. So we go next. Okay then, so this is our indoor station settings, so we have to put in a registration password here. Okay, we can use the same password as before. Intercom 123. Okay, alright, that's good. Okay, you can change up, there are other settings here, but for our purposes here right now, we're good. So we can click on next. Cloud service, we haven't got a cloud service set up, so we can go next. Okay, this is our door station. As you see, it's already found two active devices and one inactivated device, because we already have an intercom here. So that's the activated devices, and the inactive device is the door station we have here. Okay, so we're going to quickly activate it. Inactivated means basically just brand new out the box. So we're going to click on the actual model number, and it will activate it. Okay, then we have to click on the cog. As you see, now it's been activated, and then we enable DHCP. So we go there. As you see, our address is 192.0.0.65. We're going to change that in a second. Okay, so operation success. I do, it still says 192.0.0.6.5, but that should change in a second. There we go, 10.44.1.4.8. Okay, so that should all be set up now. As simple as that. Okay, so now it's taken to its main view. Let's quickly check out system working. There we go. Okay, so that's how you set it up through the panel. It's still ringing. And check out our videos to do some more advanced things like add apps and this and that. So hopefully see you there. Cheers, bye.